lúa nói đấy.
Yo ya y tú
我给他烟。宛如人暖的气囊，去爱点浪浪呀点绿，宛如美好的情谊，去爱点浪呀点绿，捉摸漫漫旅途的雨。
For this ordination service, the disciples who had locked themselves away somewhere in Jerusalem on Easter evening, these 10 were probably just a little bit older than 18. In the years they spent together, but something more needed to happen before they fully understood their call from God. Like a gang on the run, they hid in a secret location. Locked doors could keep the risen Christ from coming to them. You see, when the risen Jesus speaks, it's like the voice of God at creation, calling something new into being. They saw his scars, them very much alive. John's Gospel will include several more scenes as this new reality of Easter takes hold in the lives of those disciples, the 10 in today's story, Thomas, who will show up a week later, Mary Magdalene earlier on Easter Day, and then that small band of followers. We are all here today because they were bold in their speaking and acting and obedient when God called and sent them forth. When you assume this office, believing that the church's call is God's call to the ministry of word and sacrament. I will ask God to help me. The church in which you are to be ordained confesses that the Holy Scriptures are the Word of God and are the norm of its faith and life. We accept, teach, and confess the Apostles, the Nicene, and the Athanasian Creeds. We also acknowledge the Lutheran. Just a little window so those who are way in the far back can see what we're doing. The Lord be with you.
And also with you.
Let us give our thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right to give our thanks and praise.
Making some apostles, some prophets, some pastors and teachers to equip your people for their work of ministry, for the building up of the body of Christ. Those who are nearby, I invite you to come and lay hands on Jewish Aid. For all of you in your chairs, I invite you to raise a hand in blessing. Eternal God, through your Son, Jesus Christ, pour out your Holy Spirit upon Jewish Aid and fill him with the gifts of grace for the ministry of word and sacrament. Bless his proclamation of your word and administration of your sacraments, so that your church may be gathered for praise and strengthened for service. Make him a faithful pastor.
And again, 10 of under compulsion.
The messenger of Jesus Christ sent by God to serve all people with the gospel of hope and salvation, will you regard him as a servant of Christ?
We will, we ask God to help us.
Will you pray for him? Help and honor him for his work's sake, and in all things strive to live together in the peace and the unity of Christ.
Testing 1, 2, 3.
That's the last time I saw him.